preaching to our Lord's gospel as recorded in the book of Matthew chapter 4. Matthew chapter 4. The Lord's gospel is recorded in Matthew chapter 4. The sermon really comes from those first 11 verses. I'll just read verse 1. Matthew 4. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. Turn with me to Hebrews chapter 2. Hebrews chapter 2. We're looking at the last verse in that chapter. For in that he himself hath suffered being tempted, he is able to succor them that are tempted. For in that he was tempted himself, he is able to succor, in other words, to help those who are tempted. For a few minutes I'm going to talk from the subject affecting the antagonist. Affecting the antagonist. The last 3 weeks, and this makes my fourth installment, I've been laboring from this theme of life's problems. Life's problems. Problem of self. What is man? Got the problem of environment. Forces of our environment that work to mess us up. We have the problem of heredity. We were born in sin and shaken in iniquity. But don't fool yourself. The greatest of life's problems is this willful attack of the devil. Evil is not something that is just housed within man. On the earth, evil is something that is orchestrated, mastered, and motivated by the devil. It's his job to mess you up. I want to look at how Jesus handled his temptation. If I look at how Jesus handled his, I can better understand how I should handle mine. You ought to at least be aware that he is attacking you. Not bothering you, it's because you are promoting his program. But you know, he's going to bother you no matter what. He's like cancer. You can have it and not even know you got it. You get so used to being messed up, you get comfortable with being messed up. Let me start and talk about the constant calamity. This matter of the attacks of the devil is something that Jesus made known to us. But when I look at the Jesus man, I see he reveals to us what God really is to man. After Adam messed it up, he was separated from God. But Jesus reconciles us back to God. Jesus gives us a real picture of what man is to man. He reveals to us man's rightful role in trying to make the world a better place. But most of all, today I'm going to focus on the fact that he reveals to us this matter of evil in the world. The Bible says he was led by the Spirit. Y'all been looking today. The devil didn't lead him, the Spirit led him. let it in seclusion. He quarantined Jesus.
All right.
In the wilderness. But that was an agenda. He was motivated to go into the wilderness to be tempted there.
Amen.
Not in the Garden of Eden.
Right.
Eden is where man messed up.
Right.
God takes him not to Eden, he takes him to the wilderness.
Right. Yes.
And it's in the wilderness that he is one-on-one with the devil.
Amen. Yeah.
But first thing I notice about Satan, you see this boldness of evil, he has no problem with pushing his attack on God. And if he attacked Jesus,
yeah.
I wish I had a good
time.
He has no problem attacking you. God forgive me, deliver me from you folk who think you so holy and do all that, that the devil can't bother you. Your good record, your good reputation, your good policies, that cannot immune the devil from attacking you.
Yeah.
Y'all better hear me today. Yeah. Jesus, that wasn't the first time he was tempted. He was born in Bethlehem. He lived for 30 plus years and he knew what temptation was, but he had overcome it in the past, but now he has a special temptation.
Amen.
He's tempted. He goes into the wilderness to fast and to pray. He goes into the wilderness to commune with God. He goes into the wilderness to get close to God. But Jesus would have me let you know that you can't ever try to get close to God, not the devil trying to mess you up.
Yeah.
Every time God starts drawing you closer, the devil kind of tries to put a rope around your neck and pull you away from God.
Yeah.
On just a closer walk with thee. And that's what we sing about. But the question is, are you willing to really walk closer with it? That every time you strive to walk closer with it, the devil is going to attack you. Oh, you don't have to take my word for it. Every time you decide you're going to do right, Paul says evil is present.
Yeah.
Every time you decide you're going to read your Bible, the phone will ring. Every time you decide you're going to meditate and pray, somebody will depend on you. Every time you want to get closer to God, the children start acting a fool. Every time you want to get closer to God, something will happen to distract you to get your mind off of that which God has put in your mind.
Yeah.
He's constantly trying to attack you, and you need to understand that Satan is not like us. You know, it doesn't take anything but just a daily word, and we get discouraged. The devil won't get discouraged because you're talking your talk.
Right.
I wish I had a witness. In the name of Jesus, I push you out of the way. Well, you got to get bolder and all that. You got to understand who you're up against. Remember, he lacks it when you talk all your religious talk. He lacks it when you use your cliches and your religious phraseology. That doesn't bother the devil. Man looks at the outward appearance, but God knows the heart. And guess what? The devil is looking at your heart too. Internally, the devil is on the attack.
Yeah.
We'll have a witness here.
Yeah.
And I need to understand, the devil impulses is to do everything that is inspiring to the nature of God.
Yeah.
In other words, the motivation of the devil is just the opposite of that God is all about.
Yeah.
God is love.
Yeah.
God is light. God is liberty.
Yes.
Satan is just the opposite. Satan is not love, he's about hate.
Right.
He's not about illumination, he's about darkness.
Right. Yeah. Right.
He's not about liberating, he's about enslaving.
Amen.
He wants to get you, he wants to grab you, he wants to control you, he wants to make you do what he wants you to do. You don't have to believe. That's a drug addict. I told you, you give a hungry drug addict $5, he'll pass up the grocery store to go get him a crack. You give an alcoholic $10, he'll pass up the grocery store to go to the liquor store.
Huh.
wish I had. See, yeah. The devil lacks to control you. He lacks to enslave you. That's what these little things were all about. When we scrutinize these temptations that we read about in chapter 4, we find that they were designed to enslave.
Amen.
Notice the subtlety of Satan. Notice how evil lacks to be slick.
Yeah.
Tricky.
Yes,
his persistence and his folly. He's tricky. He's there talking to Jesus, tempting Jesus. Right. Jesus has been going through a 40-day fast, doing what the Father told him to do.
Yeah.
And then he gets there, and all of a sudden, he comes out, and the devil says, "Why don't you turn these stones into bread?"
Amen.
Well, that's a pretty decent request. I mean, bread is pretty natural. Bread is something we need to eat. Bread is something we ought to have. To be nurtured, it makes sense to make some bread. You're hungry, make some bread.
Amen.
But that's the way. That's the way that slick devil likes to work. He likes to take the simple and use it to mess you up.
Amen.
Yeah, he takes bread. That's physical. He takes the office. That's mental. He takes the trust, and that's spiritual.
Right.
That he talks about those things. That's going to enslave Jesus to be under his power. That if you can make the bread and feed your body, if you can take this office and know that I'll give you all that you see, you'll be in a higher position. If you can just trust in me, I can make something out of you. See, he likes to get you to trust it in the wrong stuff, and eat the wrong stuff, and believe in the wrong stuff, so that eventually you are messed up internally and find yourself alienated from the Father. Do I have a witness here?
Yes, Lord.
I'm talking about the attack of the devil. Well, unless I be guilty of what folks say, you're bragging so much on the devil, you're not saying anything about the Lord. I just think that, first of all, in order for you to be intelligent, an intelligent warrior, you ought to know something about your adversary.
Amen.
Strong points, you need to know his weakness.
That's right.
You need to know the best way to attack. Don't let nobody fool you. If you're not studying the devil, you need to find out what he's all about. Because if I can study what he's all about, I can understand that he'll make an attack, that I am ready for the attack. Do I have a witness here?
Yes, Lord.
All right, then I see not only this constant calamity, this matter of the devil, and he's on the attack constantly, and this revelation of God to man, and man to man, and evil to man.
Mm-hmm.
But I see the conquest. That how are we supposed to become victorious over the devil? You don't have to go far, it's right here in the text. The Bible said that Jesus was asked to satisfy a right craving. But he was asked to satisfy the right craving in the wrong way. Y'all better hear me this better. There's nothing wrong with making bread.
Amen.
Which are better witnesses.
Yes,
if anybody who's fat understands bread is good. Ain't nothing like some fresh made bread. Come on, you say it, man, brother. Ain't nothing like some freshly made bread.
Yes, sir.
When you got some butter just running. I wish I had some. Build it all down on it, and don't put no jelly on y'all mouths. Y'all get mad because y'all hungry, but you know, there's nothing wrong with making the bread, but you see, the devil wants you to make the bread at the wrong time.
Amen.
Preacher, how could it be wrong to make bread? It's wrong to make bread when God tell you to fast.
Yeah.
You see, the devil knows how to take a good gift and cause you to it's a sin to do right the wrong time. That sin is anything that is contrary to what God has told me to do.
Yeah.
I don't just sin by commission, I can sin by omission. God's will.